Hello, my name is Joshua Shirley, and I'm going to be a naval architect. Now, you may be asking yourself, what the heck is a naval architect? A naval architect designs the hulls for ships. All kinds of ships, from tankers to yachts. There are also skills needed for being a naval architect. Yeah, naval architects have to be creative, well-spoken, have good judgment, and work well with others. Took me a while to choose this career. After I had to suffer through many surveys that my tormentors, my teachers, forced me to endure, can I get an amen? Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I found out that my top two career clusters were architecture and construction and AV technology and communications. After careful consideration, I narrowed it down to my three choices: naval architect, performer, and plumber. Since I did not want to be a poor loser singing in elderly homes, I decided to become a naval architect with a performer as my opportunity cost. Now, you may be wondering, what's an opportunity cost, and why should I give a crap? But since I am so much more mentally advanced than all of you, I shall explain what an opportunity cost is. An opportunity cost is the thing you give up for your first choice, your second choice. As for me, my opportunity cost would be being a performer. When I was choosing this career, there are many positive incentives for being a naval architect. As a naval architect, my salary is huge. It's just starting out, I make $82,500 a year, which is twice as much as the teacher. I only have to take 4 years of college, and I don't have to do any special credits, so it's pretty cheap. And all the skills I need, I already have, because I'm amazing. There are also some negative incentives too. Since I'm going to be working with ships, I have to live near the ocean, so I can't live in Kansas. And since I can't live in Kansas, I won't be living near my family. And family is very important to me, because my family can't refuse when I try to leech off of them. Finally, Virginia. Well, let me explain. I was consulting with my roommates, to play with all our needs and wants. We had to move to Virginia. Let me tell you, Virginia is not the party capital of the world. It sucks. But before I can do all this, I have to go to college. Now, I was torn between two colleges, KU and the University of Virginia. There are some factors that helped me decide between the two. For KU, the average GPA for a student is 3.5. I mean, that's pretty decent, but for Virginia, it's 4.0. The graduation rate for KU is only 63%, whilst Virginia is 93%. Although VU, has all I need and is a high educational school, is out of state and is very expensive. A year at KU is only $20,421, while a year at VU is $54,752. So I decided to go to KU. After college, while I'm living the good life in Virginia, I still have to pay for things. As you can see from my pie chart, taxes take up 32% of my budget at $2,181.15. Discretionaries aren't far behind at 27%. I can't really explain why my taxes are so much, except the government is evil, but I can't explain my discretionaries. Discretionaries are all the necessities in life: food, clothes, life insurance, cable TV. So you can see why there's so much cost going into it. Also, I'm a very generous man, so I have $330 into charity, which isn't discretionaries. my budget wasn't always like this. There are a couple things I had to change. I had to put money for miscellaneous to college because I forgot you had to go to college for more than 1 year. I took money from charity to put into clothing because I need this money more than. And I put saving money into food because apparently I'm not allowed to go on a diet. I'm amazing, so I will change the world in a big way. Since I'm a naval architect, how I'll make my mark is I will make ships for the government that will spread out across the world. And that is amazing. These are the websites I use to help me get all my information. Big ones I used were CareerFusing and Arena, because they're very important to help them get me articles. Did you know that anti-diaphobia is the fear that somewhere, somehow, a duck is watching you? I don't know why this matters to my presentation, but I thought it was a pretty cool fact. Well, I'm done. Thank you for your time.